So we don't just sex to create children. We also sex to create a more sacred bond with each other, a more harmonious connection with each other. We also create feelings with each other. And in doing that, we're starting to see, ooh, I feel more connected to you. I feel more joy with you. I feel more excited about you. And in my excitement for you, I begin to feel excitement for myself. And that's where the draw comes in, and the intimacy and the enjoyment of each other. I hope I'm making sense for you guys. A lot of times we are always trying to think that sex is just about genital collision and climaxes and orgasms. And how's this lover doing this? And is this lover performing that? All of that is true. But when you escape away from all the rules, all the things you're trying to accomplish, I have had to sit down many of my male clients and tell them to stop trying to win a race to her climax. I've had so many of them trying to hurry up and get her to climax so he can finish. And I tell men, stop. Her climax is not your responsibility. Her climax will come from her pleasing you. If you're in sync with each other and your lover is excited about being in your presence, it won't take much for her to climax. If you're spending a lot of time trying to meet that goal, which the goal is, I want to see her have an orgasm, you're going to overexert yourself and you're going to lose the enjoyment of being present in the sex because you're spending so much time trying to create her to have a climax, and that creation comes from her. That makes sense. You can't create her climax. She has to do it. Stop worrying yourself to death about, is she going to climax or not? Stop. Just enjoy it. Be happy you're in that space, that sacred space. You're able to just touching each other is arousing. Touching each other is arousing. So you don't have to sit around and try to see if you're going to create an orgasm with her. Because real talk, the orgasm comes from her. She can have an orgasm without you. So you don't have to make that a mark of achievement. Just enjoy being there. Let me give you a secret, gents. Since most of you on here are here, I'm going to give you a secret that you can take to the bank in cash. Most women, we have an enjoyment of just being in your space. All the things y'all do to the body is just as important as having a climax. We want a climax bad enough, we can do it ourselves. We don't need you for that. Just giving you a heads up. Relax your mind. I'm just telling you. You guys are killing yourself trying to make a woman climax, and she does fine on her own. If you have sex with a man, and if a woman really wants to learn about climaxes, she'll learn it on her own. I learned how to do it myself. I don't need a man for that. But what I do need is intimacy. I need intimacy with a man. I need a man to explore my body. I need a man to tell me that I'm important, that he finds me attractive. I need those things. But you trying to make me climax isn't necessary. Because guess what? If I'm pleasing you, I'm getting pleasure. Period. It's just what it is. And the real women that are older and we know something about sex will tell you, our climax is not an achievement. We don't get a trophy for that. You don't get a trophy for it either. It's just what it is. Real talk. Take that to the bank. Cash that. Don't tell them I told you, but that's what it is. We are responsible for our climaxes, not y'all. I don't care if y'all working hard to get it. Stop. Because just you being all in a man's presence, honey, rubbing my body on his, rubbing on him, kissing on him is climatic enough. If I get an orgasm or if I don't, it doesn't matter. I'm just thankful that I'm there, that I'm receiving him, that I'm excited to be with him, that we have this connection sacredly. It's not his responsibility to make me climax. It's not. And any woman that tells you otherwise is not in tune with herself. Take that to the bank, babe. I'm just telling you. Listen, I've been studying sex a long ass time since I was 17. I know how to, listen, women can have sex and women can have climaxes four ways. If you don't believe me, go to my YouTube channel and check it out. Four ways a woman can have an orgasm and climax on her own. So you trying to help her to have the climax, that's not necessary. When a woman is in your presence, okay, and she begins to open to you, it's because of what's going on outside the bedroom. Uh-oh. It's what's going on outside the bedroom, baby. Are you calling her, checking on her, making sure she's good? Are you doing certain things to tell her you find her attractive and sexy? I mean, what are you doing outside the bedroom? Because let me tell you something. That is really the aphrodisiac. When you stay in touch, when you make sure that you're telling her, hey, you know, I want to see you. I can't wait to see you, or I miss you, or whatever. I love you. Whatever you want to say, or how, but be honest and authentic in what you're telling her and what you're presenting to her. And let me tell you, it don't take much for us women. It doesn't. All these cosmopolitan articles and all these to-do lists to try to get a woman to climax, y'all gonna drive yourselves crazy to try to get a woman to climax. We do it on our own. And when a woman takes her time to sexually explore herself, she knows what it takes to make her to get there, period. And if you're inquisitive about that, just say, hey, let me see, let me watch. What are you doing? I want to know. I want to engage. Can I join you? And then you might find out, oh, well, that's not even as hard as I thought it was. No, it's not. But that's not the end all to be all. You, y'all's shoulders, y'all's lips, y'all's backs, y'all's thighs, y'all's, all y'all stuff, that moves a woman. So we don't need you to try to overexert yourself to make us climax. We'll do it fine on our own. But understand this, you'll have the greatest sex when you stop trying to please her.